Hello everyone, how are you all?
I hope you all are fine and doing well at home. Now again it's time for maths lecture. So my dear students, let us start. In the last lecture, we had started a new exercise, that is exercise 3.6. We had started and done question number 1. So today, we are going to start the question number 2. Question number 1 was based on estimated sum. And today's question, that is question number 2, it is based on estimated difference. See, as in yesterday's lecture, I have told the difference between actual and estimated sum or difference. So when we will subtract the round off number, when we subtract the rounded off number, the result we call it as estimated difference. So whatever the numbers given by the question is, first we will round them off and then we will subtract the rounded off numbers, then we will call it as estimated difference. The result we will call it as estimated difference. Again, first of all we will round off the given number by the question, then we will subtract the rounded off numbers. The whatever the difference or the result we will get, we will call it as estimated difference. And if we subtract the actual numbers given by the question, then we will call them actual difference. Okay? If we are subtracting numbers given by the question, it means the whatever difference we will get, we will call it as actual difference. And if we round off them and we subtract the rounded off numbers, then we will call it as estimated difference. Okay? So, all of you, note down the question with me. First, find the actual difference. Actual difference means we will subtract the actual numbers given by the question. First, find the actual difference. And then find the estimated difference. And then find the estimated difference. So, first of all, we will find the actual difference, then we will find the estimated difference. So, let's start solving part A. 77 minus 18. 77 minus 18. See, first of all, we will write the places. Since two digit number is there, 77 and 18, both the numbers are having two digits. Two digit numbers are there, so we will write two places. That is tens and ones. Okay? Now, if we subtract the actual numbers given by the question. If we subtract the actual numbers, then we will get the actual difference. So, let's subtract actual numbers given by the question. Okay, so students, 7 minus 8, as we always start from the rightmost position, 7 minus 8. Now, can we subtract 8 from 7? Can we subtract 8 from 7? No, we cannot subtract. Why? Because 8 is the bigger number and we always subtract a smaller number from the bigger number. We always subtract a smaller number from the bigger number. So, for making this number bigger, we'll borrow a 10. For making this number bigger, we'll borrow a 10. So this 7 will become 6 and we'll give a 10 to this one's full number, and this 7 will become number 17 after taking a 10. So 17 minus 8. So all of you count 17 finger marks. Count 17 finger marks. Now minus 8 is there. So count 8 times backward now. Minus 8 is there. So count 8 times backward. How many finger marks are left? Count them. First of all, count 17 finger marks. Then minus 8 is there. So count 8 finger marks. So count 8 times backward. Now count the remaining finger marks. So how many finger marks are left? 9. So we will write the number 9. Okay, we will write the number 9. Now we are done with ones column. Moving towards tens. 6 minus 1. 6 minus 1 is there. 6 minus 1. So remember subtraction property. Whenever 1 is subtracted from any number, the result is previous number. So what is the previous number of 6? It is the number 5. So our difference or actual difference is 59. Now for calculating estimated difference, first of all we will round off the given number, 77. See, the number 77 has 7 number at one's place. At one's place 77 has number 7. That is greater than 5, it means we will round up. 77 is having 7 at one's place. So that is greater than number 5, it means we will round it up. Round it up to 8080. Now 18, the next number is 18. See, the number 18 is having 8 at ones place and the number 8 is greater than 5. It means again we will round up. Round up to 20. Again we will round it up to 20. Now if we subtract them, then we will get the estimated difference. If we will subtract the rounded off values, then we will get the estimated difference. So 0 minus 0, 0 minus 0 is 0. So we will write the number 0. Now 8 minus 2, 8 minus 2 is 6. So we will write the number 6. So see, we subtracted the actual numbers given by the question and got the actual difference. Then we rounded off the given numbers, then subtracted them and got estimated difference. So let's write the answer. So in the answer, we'll write about actual difference and estimated difference. What question is asked us? So actual difference is 59 and estimated differences, and estimated differences 60. So all of you note down the question, note down the solution. Note down the solution quickly, dear students. First, we subtracted the given numbers, that are the actual numbers given by the question, and got the actual difference. Then, we rounded off the given numbers and then subtracted them, and our result is estimated difference. Note down, students. In beautiful handwriting, good, neat and clean handwriting.
dear students, I hope you all have noted down now. Let's do part B. All of you read the next question. And this you have to note down in your class for copy. All the exercises, whatever given in the book, you will note them down in your class for copy. Okay, all of you read the next question, that is part B. The estimation topic you have learned in class 2 also. So I hope this topic is very easy for you dear all. Now the next question, part B is 88 minus 44. Part B. 88 minus 44. So again, for finding out the actual difference, by subtracting the actual given number. So let's do it. As we always start from the rightmost position, here also we'll start from the first place. 8 minus 4. So all of you open 8 fingers. Open 8 fingers, dear students. Now minus 4 is there. So now close 4 fingers out of those 8. Now count the remaining fingers. How many fingers are left? Very good. 4 fingers are left. So we will write the number 4. So 8 minus 4 is equals to 4. See, again 8 minus 4 is given there. We just learned 8 minus 4. And these numbers are also same, 8 minus 4. So result will be also same. So 88 minus 44 is equals to 44. Now this is our actual difference. We subtracted the actual given numbers. So we got the actual difference. Now let's find the estimated difference by rounding them off. So first of all, let's round off number 88. See, look at number 88. Number 88 is having 8 at one place. So the number 8 is bigger than 5. It means we will round it up. So we will round it up, 88 to 90. Now the second number is 44. The another number is 44. See the number 4. So at one's place, the number 4 is there. Number 4 is lesser than 5. It means we will round it down. So we will round it down to 40. Let's subtract it. See, this is our rough work. We'll not note this down in copy. This is rough work. Okay, so let's subtract it. As we always start from the rightmost place, again we'll one more time. And this is the correct way. We'll start from the first place. So 0 minus 0. 0 minus 0 is equals to 0. So we'll write the number 0. 9 minus 4. 9 minus 4. So all of you open 9 fingers. Open 9 fingers. The minus 4 is there. So now close 4 fingers. Minus 4 is there. So close 4 fingers. 9 minus 4. Now count the remaining fingers. How many fingers are left? 5 fingers are left. So we will write the number 5. Okay. So this is our estimated difference and this is our actual difference. We had found out the both. Let's write the answer. We will write about actual difference first. Actual difference is 44 and estimated difference is 5050. So all of you note down the solution and be remember while making these tables or this line, make it with the help of scale or ruler. All of you note down quickly with good handwriting. all of you, note down quickly. Dear students, note down quickly but with good handwriting and neat and clean. Now I hope, dear students, you all have noted down. Now moving towards next question. That is part C. All of you read part C. All of you read the question, part C. Part C is 73 minus 68. Part C is 73 minus 68. So, first of all, we will subtract the actual numbers given by the question for finding out the actual difference. So, 3 minus 8. 3 minus 8. Three minus eight is, we always start from the rightmost position. Three minus eight. Can we subtract three? Can we subtract eight from three? No, because this is the bigger number. So let's borrow. This seven will become six, then this three will become 13. Now 13 minus eight. All of you subtract eight from 13 and tell me the answer. Very good. The number five. The number 5. So we will write the number 5. Now, tens column, 6 minus 6. Remember subtraction property. Whenever the number is subtracted from itself, the result is 0 or the difference is 0. So 73 minus 68 is equals to 5. Now for finding out the estimated difference, we will round off the given number 73. Number 73 is having 3 at 1's place, that is lesser than 5. So we will round it down to 70. 68 is having 8 at 1's place, so it is greater than 5. So again we will round it up to 70. Now we will subtract the rounded off number. So 0 minus 0, 0 minus 0 is 0, so we will write the number 0. Now 7 minus 7, again whenever the number is subtracted from itself, the result is 0, so we will write again 0. So see, here our estimated difference is 0 and the actual difference is 5. So let's write about the answer. Let's write the answer. Actual difference is 5, it means 5, and estimated difference is 0. So all of you note it down. See, first of all we will subtract the actual numbers given by the question for getting the actual difference, and then we'll round off the numbers for getting the estimated difference. If we subtract the rounded off numbers, then we will call it as estimated difference.
So this is all for today's lecture, dear students. We will meet in next lecture. Till then, bye bye students. Stay home, stay safe, and keep practicing all the topics. Bye bye students.